हेलो ऑल, वेलकम टू जावा टेक। टुडे वी लर्न टू क्रिएट आवर फर्स्ट मेवन प्रोजेक्ट। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम, लेट्स डू इट। टू क्रिएट मेवन प्रोजेक्ट्स, मेवन प्रोवाइड अस अ वे और मैकेनिज्म कॉल्ड आर्कटाइप मैकेनिज्म। लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड वॉट आर्कटाइप इज। आर्कटाइप इज लाइक अ टेम्पलेट ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट इन विच मेवन हैव डिफाइंड द डायरेक्टरी स्ट्रक्चर एंड मिनिमल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर्म टू गेट अ रेडी टू रन प्रोजेक्ट। We are required to give it two main inputs, group ID and artifact ID. Group ID is used to categorize, provide a unique identifier to a group of projects. For example, in Maven, there is a group ID which is called org.apache.maven.plugin. All the plugins in Maven are created under this particular group ID. And the another artifact ID. Artifact ID is just the name of our project. For example, that we also saw earlier, in this particular group ID, we have a project having artifact name Maven Archetype plugin. We have so many plugins apart from this. We can verify this in my local repository. This is my local repository. We can see that there are so many plugins, and all these plugins have the same particular group ID, but different artifact IDs. These folder names are the artifact IDs or the project names. There is one thing to note here. Just see the path here. Remember the group ID that we saw earlier? That was org apache maven plugins. This is the path at which all these plugins are kept, and this is the path of my local repository. We will discuss why it is like this in our further sessions. For now, just note it down. Now let's create our first project. To create the project, just use this command. Open the terminal using Ctrl+Alt+T. Just paste the command here. It will download all the plugins and all the jars required to create this project. Yes, the project is created now using this group ID and this particular name that we have provided in the command. This and this. Let's see what we get after creating this project. We get a folder, namely MyApp, which was the artifact ID. We get a directory structure in MyApp folder, and we get a pom.xml. Let's see, do we really get these? Let's get back to the terminal. ls-lhtr to see all the directories. This was the directory that was last updated, that is our app. Let's go inside the directory and see. We got the pom and the directory structure, which is source and having many folders inside this. Let's see the overall directory structure. Let's get back to my app folder. Clear the console and just type tree. Now here we can see the directory structure. Pom, source is the main folder. In my app folder we have two things. One is the pom and .xml. Another is the source folder. In source we have two folders, main and test. In main we have Java, in test also we have Java. After this Java folder, this here com, my company and app, these three are created by using our group ID that we provided earlier while creating the project. And this is our app.java, and this is the test class for this particular class. I have also attached the picture of this particular directory structure in the PPT. You can download this PPT from the description. Let's move ahead now. Let's see what POM is. POM is the blueprint of the project. All the jars that we use externally and all the plugins that we use are defined in this particular file. To understand this, we can take the example of a class.
A class is a blueprint of the object. It defines all the variables and its data types that object will comprise of. Likewise, pom.xml is a file which is the blueprint of whole project. Now let's see the structure of the pom. This here on the screen we can see the structure of the pom. The first tag, the main tag, the parent tag, which is project. This particular tag consists all the dependencies, all the properties, all the plugins that we are defining in the project. This here is the group ID that we defined earlier, artifact IDs that we defined earlier. This is the version of the project. By default, the version is 1.0 snapshot. These are the properties. These are like the variables that can be used in these pom. And these are the dependencies, external projects, external jars that we are using in our project. We will be learning all these things in our further sessions. For now, just note these. Thank you for watching the video. Java Tech signing off.